In this video, we're going to do a tour of the Instagram clone. So this is a minimum viable product. So it is a basic version of some of the key features of Instagram that we have built into this application. And if you want to purchase this application, it's for sale on my website. You can get the link in the description below. So it includes a bunch of different features that are part of Instagram. And as you can see here, that the price tag is $199, and you can purchase it directly from the site. And I also have a link here for the demo if you want to check out the demo yourself. But this video will give some additional information about features I've added to this application and how you can use it for your own startup or your own app concept. So we have this sign up page with all of the key details, but I have an account already, so I'm going to sign in using that account. And once you're signed in, we will see the list of posts on the left side of the screen. So that is our feed of posts. So anyone that we follow, we will see their posts on the left side of the screen. And we have some things here like likes and comments. So you can like and comment any post. And once you do that, you will see the number change underneath. So we've got one like or two likes, and the button is highlighted in red once you like it. Another new feature I've added here is the way in which the posts are loaded in. So it is a never-ending loading of posts until you actually run out of content in the application. So in this case, once you get to the bottom, you'll see no more posts to display. So what's actually happening here in the background is it's loading in 5 posts at a time. And once you scroll to the bottom of the browser, it will then load an additional 5 posts, and it will continue that cycle until you run out of content. So that way we're keeping the app optimized. We're not loading all of the data in at once. And if we look at the right side of the screen here, we've got this follow section. So we can follow users. And an additional thing that I've added recently is this ad section. So you can have these banner adverts if you are signed in as the admin user. So an admin user can add adverts to the platform, and that allows you to monetize the site in a way so you can have a link to an external website and you can schedule a start and end date for that banner advertisement. So on the front end of the feed, these adverts are actually pulled in at random. So if there's multiple active adverts on that date, we can see that they are pulled in randomly. So I have 2 that are active at the moment. Another feature I've added is the search field at the top of the site. So you'll see the search box, and what this does is it allows you to search for users and it will find them in real time. So once you type the name, it will search in the background. So it's an autocomplete. So even if you do half of the name, it will pull in multiple results. It allows you then to click into their profiles. So we click on the profile and it will take me to that page. So this is a profile page, and you can see the posts that this user has made. And once we hover them, you'll see this comments and likes on the hover effect. We can also unfollow this user at the top of the page. So let's click on one of the posts that they've made. So here we can leave a comment. So if you click that little comment icon, it automatically highlights the comment field. So we'll type a comment. So we'll say nice photo. And once we do this, it will add it to the little comment window above. So we can see that it's posted less than a minute ago. If we want to create a new post, we can do that using the link in the navigation menu. So we'll simply add a photo and a description and post that photo. So going back to my profile now, you can see I've got some details in here. We've got the posts, number of posts, the number of followers and following. And you can click into those to see who you are following, who your followers are, and who you are actually following. So the people you're following are the posts that you will see. You will see those posts from those users in your timeline or in your feed on the dashboard. So editing account, then you can simply change the details here. You can add a website, and you can also edit the description, which will appear on your profile page. So going back to the dashboard, we can actually follow users using the suggestions box. And in this case, I've only got a few users on this platform. So I've already followed pretty much all of them. So you can see that the field is blank now once you've run out of users to follow. The icon for the comment on the dashboard, it will actually take you to that post. And it just gives you more control over adding comments. So once we add comments here, it will update in the view above. So it'll always load the newest comment at the top. And the same with the feed, always the newest post will appear at the top of the feed from those people that you're following. So going back to the adverts section, I want to look at that in a little bit more detail. So we'll click on the adverts, and if you add a new banner, so adding a new banner here, we can add the start date. So I've used a drop-down field to control the dates here. So you pick the date when the advert begins and when it ends. So when it ends after that date, then it will no longer be visible on the website. And you place it then on the sidebar. So it's just a very simple way to control those on the front end. I have added this static page just to give you a brief idea of how these adverts could work. So you can define your own pricing. And at the moment, the payment is handled outside of the app. So you would take a payment, maybe via PayPal or something similar, and then place the adverts on the app using the feature in the top navigation. If you want to use this application for your own project or for your own startup as a template to get you off the ground, you can purchase it on my website using the link in the description below. And make sure to check that out, play around with it, and see if it fits what you need. If it's useful to you, then it will save you a lot of time and a lot of money getting started with this project. So hopefully you found this video helpful, and if you have any more questions on the Instagram clone, make sure to drop them in the comments below, and I will see you all in the next video.